GMA, the latest on the new midterm results coming in overnight. Another Trump-backed candidate loses, with the former president expected to announce that he's running for a third time. Plus, we have an ABC News exclusive and an interview with former Vice President Mike Pence, what he says about Trump running again. And some new details on the deadly campus shooting at the University of Virginia. The suspect set to face a judge. You're going to see those stories and so much more right here on GMA.
Okay, don't forget, our KSAC Community Share the Shoes campaign is happening right now. You can donate a new pair of shoes or socks to a child in need. Just take your donation to any of the San Antonio Police substations. You can see those locations right there on your screen through December 16th. That's all for now. It's 5:57. In just a bit, ahead in our next half hour, actress Christina Applegate gets emotional during her speech for her first public appearance since being diagnosed with MS. Taking a look outside with Transguide, not a lot of incidents happening on the road this morning. RJ Marquez in for our Stephen Cavazos. He'll have a look at traffic, and of course, Mike will have our forecast when we come back.
Ahead this hour, one person is in the hospital and another is on the run after a shooting on the southeast side. We're going to tell you what police know so far.
Well, you think I would need one.
Oh, long job.
Oh, you hate to see that. All right, a rough night for our silver and black while they're in California. They fall to the high-powered Golden State Warriors. We have a recap and a look ahead to the Spurs' next game.
And taking a look outside with live cam this morning, we're starting in the 40s, nice and cool for those of you who like the colder weather.
Live from KSAT 12, Good Morning San Antonio starts right now.
Good morning. Happy Tuesday morning. It's November 15th. So excited to be on the desk with Steph this morning.
Yeah, thanks for joining me. We've been having lots of conversations about Thanksgiving and No Shade November, Smolder. We'll get into it later.
We've been teaching all the men what a smolder means.
Seems to be working with the donations.
It works because we get a guy to smolder on camera, their donations get bumped up.
So my question is, because the gentlemen that have smoldered are actually doing this. Do you have to actually have your hand at your chin, or can you just do that, the...
You know, that's a preference. What makes you feel more confident? I think a smolder is like what makes a man feel confident. That's like their confident look, you know?
Yeah, so it could go either way.
So go ahead, Mike.
See, now, it's like trying to
whistle
with somebody else. Now she's talking about I can't do it. I'm like,
just putting him on the spot.
That's okay. Mike's in the lead.
Need a smolder.
The smolders and the ember. Anyway, what I see, they're smolders, and I say I'm the ash left over after the smolder with the gray. Yeah. So, come on, Team Gray Hair. We don't need a smolder. We just need, go for it. It's 40 right now here in town. 34 Bernie Stage Comfort as well as Kerrville. So your backyard may be below freezing as of right now. 38 in Helotes, 37 in Valverde. And we do have a wind chill to deal with right now. It's fairly decent breeze out there. 28 in Bernie Stage. 26 is what it feels like at Kerrville, and 35 out there at the airport, Port SA, as well as Randolph. And it feels like 33 in Valverde as well as New Braunfels. Winds, there's not a lot out there, but again, these cold temperatures doesn't take much. Gusts to 16 in Kerrville, 19 Lost Maples, and mold is on the moderate side. The updated count is going to be coming out in about an hour, hour and a half. And throughout the rest of the morning, we're not going to drop down too much more from where we are. Where we are right now, because of the breeze out there, doesn't allow the heaviest, coolest air to settle down here to the surface. If you have no wind at all, that's when you get the coldest temperatures. But of course, we have that wind chill to deal with. So we'll see some sunshine. There are a couple of clouds hanging around here, and we'll see a few of them here and there. A lot of high clouds throughout the day. We're going to make it up through the upper 40s and get up to 52 degrees by noon. Then we're going to be topping off at 58 later on this afternoon. I'm going to call it mostly sunny skies. A lot of high clouds out there, but still a nice looking day. Next couple of days, just about the same thing. Then we get into Friday and the weekend. Got another front coming on in here, and it's going to bring some rain with it, and it's going to be a cold rain. Details on that coming up in just a couple of minutes. Traffic Authority, RJ Marquez, what's going on, sir?
All right, Mike, not too much going on the roads. Not sure if people stayed up late to watch that Spurs game. Hopefully that was not the case, because that was not a fun night for the silver and black. But we're going to take you out to this one incident that I've been following throughout the morning. This is at Loop 410 and Ingram North, our TransGuide traffic camera. And there's reports of a stalled vehicle there. But as you can see, traffic still moving along pretty smooth in that area. As we take a look at our traffic flow now from our maps, again, the eastbound lanes of Loop 410 at Ingram Road, right next to Ingram Park Mall. Again, nothing major to show as far as any sort of delays in that area. But again, if you see those emergency vehicles, just make sure to pull over and give them room to do what they have to do out there. All right, bird's eye view of things going on across the cities. You could see, again, maybe people just getting a little bit of a later start this morning. This one accident, again, is off the highway. That's at Wagner and South Zarzamora, so nothing major to show for there as we go back outside. And again, this is our only thing that we're following this morning. Things pretty quiet out there. Sarah and Stephanie, back to you guys.
Thank you, RJ. San Antonio police are keeping a close eye on a northeast side neighborhood, which was the site of a shooting a little more than an hour ago.
So they've roped off part of an apartment complex on Fairdale Drive near Riddiman Road and I-35. Katrina Weber is live at the scene. Now, Katrina, we understand you've learned some new information about the shooting.
Well, that's right. Just a little while ago, got a chance to talk to the sergeant here, and he confirmed it's a 25-year-old man who was shot, hit in his stomach and also in his arm by gunfire right before 5 o'clock this morning. Now, since then, police have had this area roped off. They're working here at the Parker apartment homes. And as you can see, right there in the middle are a pair of shoes that we believe are the victim's shoes, right next to a paramedic glove. So it appears that's where they were able to work on him. Police also have some markers on the ground where they have found evidence. Now, they have been going around this apartment complex. We saw them going in and out of one unit in particular. We also saw them come out with a man in handcuffs. They told us that this is all part of their sweep that they've been doing sort of for safety purposes, someone that they had dealt with before who they have in custody. But for now, he is not connected to the shooting this morning. They're still looking for the shooter, who they describe as wearing a red hoodie and having dreadlocks. Police also had their helicopter up as they searched this area, but so far they have not made any arrests. They say the man who was shot is stable. These are non-life-threatening wounds, but again, he was hit in his stomach and his arm by someone who shot him, apparently during some sort of an argument. Reporting live on the northeast side, Katrina Weber, KSAT 12 News.
Thank you, Katrina. A lot of questions this morning after a shooting at an apartment complex last night. So this happened around 9:30 on East South Cross near Pecan Valley. Details are limited at this time. However, police tell us one person is in the hospital after being shot in the back. Two apartment units were also hit by gunfire, but there are no reports of any other injuries. So far, no one has been arrested.
Firefighters still trying to figure out what sparked a blaze at a West Side home. It happened last night on West Magnolia near Calavetas. Crews had their hands full with those flames. Fortunately, no one was hurt. Another house behind the fire did take on some damage as well. And change is in the air. You can feel it. It's chilly outside. And while many of us enjoy the cooler weather, not everyone is as enthusiastic.
Nonprofits that help the homeless and needy families in our community are stocking up on warm clothing and hats and coats. If you have gently used winter clothing, agencies like Corazon San Antonio, Haven for Hope, and SAM Ministries can all put them to good use. Haven for Hope encourages people to host their own small-scale winter donation drives in their own communities or churches.
People like to give this time of year, and so we do receive a lot of donations, and we're grateful for it, but the need is there beyond the holidays into January, February, and March. So the more that we can have on hand and have available, the better.
Later today, more than half a dozen local nonprofits will join forces with the city to launch Hunger and Homelessness Awareness Week. It is meant to help bring food and comfort to the most need in our community.
Some other top stories we're following for you this morning. Republicans are on the cusp of retaking control of the House, just one victory shy of the 218 seats the party needs to secure a majority.
Control of the House would give conservatives leverage to slow down President Joe Biden's agenda and spur a flurry of investigations. But a slim numerical advantage could pose immediate challenges for GOP leaders and complicate the party's ability to govern. The full scope of the party's majority may not be clear for several more days or weeks as votes in competitive races are still being counted. Still, the party is on track to achieve 218 with seats in California and other states still too early to call. In your morning consumer headlines, interest rates still almost certain to go up again when the Federal Reserve meets next month, but maybe not quite as fast. Fed Vice Chair Leah Brainard, speaking on Monday, indicated the Fed may be eyeing a half-point hike following four straight hikes of three-quarters of a point.
40 states have now agreed to settle an investigation over Google's location tracking for over $390 million. The investigation started after an Associated Press report back in 2018 showed that Google kept information on where people had been, even if they had disabled that in their phone.
Six airlines have now agreed to refund more than $600 million to travelers whose trips were changed or canceled during the pandemic. The Department of Transportation also fining the airlines $7 million.
And your GMA First Look Thanksgiving dinner is going to cost you more this year. Prices are up nearly 17% compared to last year, but there are some ways you can save money. Look for that story and more coming up at 7 a.m. right here on KSAT 12. It's going to start looking a little more like Christmas today.
That's because San Antonio's official Christmas tree is on the way, and it's coming all the way from Oregon in the Pacific Northwest, and it should arrive at Travis Park later this morning.
Yeah, HEB says the tree will stand nearly 50 feet tall and will be decorated with 10,000 white lights and dozens of colorful ornaments. It's all for the 30th annual HEB tree lighting celebration.
It kicks off the day after Thanksgiving on November 25th at 3 p.m.
Love to see that. All right, it's 6:10 and in the 40s.
And coming up, much more, including the new developments at the University of Virginia after a gunman killed three of his fellow students. That's coming up a little later on GMSA.
And just ahead, after the break, Christina Applegate making her first appearance since the actress was diagnosed with MS. You won't want to miss her emotional speech on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
And it feels like November out there. Taking a look outside with live cam, if you're a fan of the cold weather, yay, we're in the 40s, but it will warm up for a nicer day. We'll be right back. And welcome back at 6:14. Actress Christina Applegate appeared at a public event for the first time since being diagnosed with MS.
ABC's Lionel Moyes reports on the star's emotional speech as she was honored in Hollywood.
Christina Applegate!
This morning, Christina Applegate getting her own star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
This day means more to me than you could possibly imagine.
The Emmy-winning actress making her first public appearance since announcing she was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis or MS in August of last year. With a bedazzled cane in hand, Applegate in her true fashion making jokes.
Oh, by the way, I have a disease. Did you not notice?
The autoimmune disease affects the central nervous system. Symptoms can include dizziness, numbness, weakness, and vision problems. Applegate's co-stars from the 80s sitcom Married with Children were among those speaking at the ceremony, saying how much she inspires them.
And you bend and you don't break. And your humility and irreverence allows all of us to bend with you.
The laughs that our cast and crew shared were genuinely special. Christina and I are truly like brother and sister, even to this day.
The 50-year-old actress thanked a list of people who made her career in Hollywood possible, her friends, her family, and this touching tribute to her 11-year-old daughter, Sadie.
You are so much more than even you know. You are so beautiful and kind and loving and smart and interesting, and I am blessed every day that I get to wake up and take you to your school and do what I have. You are my everything.
Thanking Sadie for standing beside her through everything.
Studies estimate more than a million people in the U.S. are living with MS, and right now there is no cure, but there are several treatment options. Lionel Moyes, ABC News, New York.
All right, and taking you outside and a look at traffic this morning, and things looking pretty good out there on our roadways, US 90 at Medio Creek. Things looking solid there. I-10 at West Avenue, traffic moving along very smoothly across our area as we take a look at this one incident that has been following for the past couple of minutes or so. A stall out there, the eastbound lanes of Loop 410 at Ingram Road, right next to Ingram Park Mall. I was looking at TransGuide traffic cameras earlier, and it looks like things are pretty good there. Not too much of a backup you could see from our traffic flow as well. Things looking pretty good. A wider view of our map, and even that one smaller accident that was there on the south side has been cleared out, so a lot of green on our screen. Things looking pretty solid. Want to let some people know about some inbound times this morning. We're talking about Pleasanton and downtown, 28 minutes, Castroville to downtown, 30 minutes, and Lytle to downtown, 16 minutes, as we take you back outside TransGuide this morning. And guys, it has been slow going on the roads. That would be the perfect time for you guys to head out to work or school on this Tuesday morning.
Much better today than it was yesterday.
Definitely. I agree. But still, a hoodie and a jacket maybe for some of the kiddos at the school bus.
Because we've got temperatures that are actually down close to freezing in portions of the hill country. Here in town, we have dropped down to 40 degrees. Got a few clouds around here right now. And there's wind chill readings that are even in the metropolitan area that are down. I'm going to show you these in just a couple of down
cover
in the
ears.
Low 30s. So
cover the ears.
Yes, indeed. And 58 for a high temperature later on today. That's it. We're going to be 10 to 15 degrees below normal. A lot of high clouds hanging around here. I'm still going to call it mostly sunny skies. Again, those few.
I was moving the bus along.
Get to school already.
I need the traffic guy to direct traffic with the animation on his desk
along.
Here. Speaking of bundling up and covering the ear, well, his ears aren't covered though.
Can't fit him in that jacket. Poor guy.
So the look on his face was, don't make me go out or don't make me wear this. What is it?
Probably don't make me go out if it's early in the morning, right?
Absolutely not. Too cold.
Good point. Probably wants to go back to bed. Make sure you scan that QR code and download some of these KSAT Connect pictures. So there's some of those clouds. We had a lot of clear skies overnight. That was the lack of blanket on top of us. That allowed temperatures to really drop down. Now we're going to sort of stabilize now that we've got this blanket moving in here right now. And this is, you can see on the satellite picture, some of this moisture aloft in the atmosphere that's coming on in here. So it's not going to be completely socked in with clouds today, but a lot of that, like I said, the high cloudiness out there. 34 right now in Comfort, Bernie Stage, 33 Kerrville, 40 here in town, and some 37s there, Helotes, as well as in Balverde. And then the wind chill temperatures. Feels like 35 out there at the airport. Randolph, 28 Bernie Stage, 25 right now is the wind chill. Yeah, so bundle up, needless to say, and you're going to need to bundle up throughout the rest of the week going into the weekend as well as next week. The normal high temperature is low 70s. There's nothing near that all the way through the middle part of next week. 10, 15 degrees, 20 degrees below normal as far as the weekend is concerned. 49 on Saturday, that's it. 53 on Sunday. Plus, we're going to have some just cloudy skies, some rain, mist, drizzle on over the weekend. It's going to be one of those days just to, again, hunker down inside, and low temperatures will stay well below the average low temperature of 50 all the way in through about the middle part of next week. So here's what it looks like around the country. This is an Arctic air mass that invaded from Canada. Everybody except the extreme southeastern portion of the country right there around Florida. And yeah, I mean, it's a huge mass of cold air that is just kind of pushing its way all the way down from the Arctic Circle through Canada and in here. And like I said, it's going to be sticking around for a while, these colder temperatures. 52 at noon today, partly cloudy skies. High temperature is going to make it up to 58. I'm going to call it mostly sunny. There's going to be some high clouds out there. Also, a bit of a breeze, not as windy as what some of the areas are recording this morning, but just enough to kind of add that little bit of a extra nip to these cooler temperatures. And then tomorrow, 38, 37 Thursday morning. So once again, close to freezing in the hill country. A few more clouds around tomorrow. Friday, the next front approaches, and then we're going to get some of that overrunning cloudiness. So plenty of clouds hanging around here. It'll still be 60, but then 49 Saturday, 53 Sunday with some showers around here. Windy on Saturday. Again, that's a grilled cheese and soup. Watch a bunch of movies, sit on the couch.
For sure.
Have you started watching your Hallmark movies yet?
Of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
So that started what, last week?
A couple of months ago, maybe.
Oh my God.
They got Hallmark in July, so. Ooh,
no, yes, but the Christmas. But like the Hallmark Christmas.
They have Hallmark
the
Christmas in July.
Yeah. And you watch them in July?
Don't get a close-up.
No shame in his Hallmark game.
Now, yes, I do so. Yeah.
Testimonials.
So yeah.
Aww. Well, his reviews will be coming in shortly. It's 6:21.
Close up, Bumpy Robert.
So funny. And did you stay up to watch the Spurs game last night? The Silver and Black had a date with the Golden State Warriors. We're going to have the highlights right after the break.
Ladies, 6 minutes, please.
This is my life. It's not always picture perfect. Plus, I'm dealing with bleeding from uterine fibroids. Enter MyFembree, a once-daily pill for women with heavy menstrual bleeding due to uterine fibroids.
With MyFembree, heavy bleeding went down by 84%. Serious risks include heart attack, stroke, and blood clots. Don't take MyFembree if you've had any of these or have uncontrolled high blood pressure, are over 35 and smoke, could be pregnant, or have or had osteoporosis, liver disease, undiagnosed vaginal bleeding, certain cancers, or an allergic reaction to it. Don't use longer than 2 years as bone loss may occur. Pregnancy loss can occur and changes in periods may make it hard to know if you're pregnant. If you think you are, stop taking it right away. Other risks are depression, suicidal thoughts or actions, abnormal liver tests, high blood pressure, and passing of the fibroid.
Less bleeding, same life? I'll take it.
Ask your doctor about MyFembree.
My life, MyFembree.
Our San Antonio Spurs began their West Coast road trip last night.
The first stop was San Francisco, where they took on the Golden State Warriors. So the Warriors have not looked like themselves as of late, going into last night's game with a 5-8 record, but they turned the page on that storyline real quick.
Yeah, Golden State was led by guard Jordan Poole, who finished the 36 points of the night. And while the Spurs held their own for a while, they just could not stop the high-powered Warrior offense. The final from the Chase Center is Golden State had 132, San Antonio 95.
And the next game does not get any easier for the Silver and Black. They stay on the West Coast to take on the Portland Trail Blazers. Portland is one of the best teams in the NBA right now, and currently they sit at first place in the Western Conference.
It's another late matchup, so you'll have to stay up late if you want to watch it. Tip-off is set for 9 o'clock tonight. We'll bring you all the highlights tomorrow morning on GMSA.
That's way too late, but go Spurs go, definitely.
Go Spurs go.
Time now, 6:26, and we are starting your morning in the 40s.
Still ahead in our next half hour, GMSA, how much do you know about e-cigarettes? The warning from health experts, that's coming up.
Gunshots ring out in this apartment complex, sending a man to the hospital. Good morning, I'm Katrina Weber. Police have been here on the northeast side investigating ever since. I'll tell you what they believe was at the root of this shooting, coming up.
It's another morning. You're going to need, you know, a heavy coat, a hat, a scarf, maybe if your fingers are sensitive, some gloves. 41 degrees at 6:29. Mike will have our forecast in just a bit.
Good morning. It is Tuesday, November 15th. And yeah, it's a little cold this morning, but at least we're not dealing with the rain.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, yesterday, that like constant drizzle. It just made it bone cold almost.
Well, when you have all that moisture in the atmosphere, because moisture actually conducts heat. Whereas dry air does not conduct heat, so that's why you tend to get colder when it's, you know, that moist out there, when you have that light rain. And that's going to be the situation come the weekend, because we're going to have more rain and very cold temperatures. Right now, as you can see, we do have a few clouds out there and nice looking sunrise, though. Cold temperatures, yeah, like Sarah was saying, do definitely bundle up. 40 right now, dew point stands at 30, so the air is much drier than it was at this time yesterday. Obviously, we don't have any mist or drizzle out there. Still got a bit of a breeze, so with that, we've got a wind chill, which down to 35 here in town. By the way, let me go back on this graphic, and you can see 33 at Kerrville, 34 Bernie Stage, Comfort, freezing at Lost Maple, so it may be freezing, obviously, in your backyard, some of the lower-lying areas out there in the hill country. And then the wind chill temperatures, 25 Kerrville, 35 at the airport, Port SA, 36 in Balverde right now. Mold is on the moderate side. The update account's going to be coming out in about an hour or so. And a couple of clouds hanging around here, cold and breezy. And then later on this afternoon, I'm going to call it mostly sunny skies. We're going to have a lot of kind of high clouds hanging around here, but we'll have more sunshine. Upper 50s, that's it. We did enough sunshine yesterday and a somewhat milder start to where we did make it up in the mid-60s, but it's not going to be that warm today. And again, kind of a breeze. More of the same, staying chilly the next couple of days, cold in the morning, upper 50s in the afternoon. Then Friday and the weekend, it's going to be cold, it's going to be wet. and bone chilling, just like yesterday morning was. Details coming up in just a couple of minutes. Traffic Authority, RJ, what's going on, sir?
Yeah, Mike, so traffic's starting to build up a little bit, but nothing major to report this morning on our major roadways. I-37 at Houston, it's a still shot there from our TransGuide traffic cameras, and then we have 1604 at Petrenko, another still shot. You see traffic moving pretty good in that area. 410 at Fredericksburg Road. Things looking pretty solid here, and we are taking now a look at our bird's eye view of the city of San Antonio. Interesting here, this is being reported as a crash on our maps, but I was looking at the San Antonio fire page. It looks like they're actually working a fire. So this is in the 600 block of Hackberry Street. So just be cautious if you're still going to be in this area. I'll try to continue to get a little bit more information about what exactly is going on there. But obviously there's something that the fire department is working in that area. So some inbound times we showed you earlier, some people coming in from the south side and the southwest side. Take you a little bit north here, Burney to downtown, 24 minutes, things looking pretty good. Bulverde to downtown, we know this always gets kind of busy here, 281 southbound, 31 minutes. And then southbound I-35, New Braunfels to downtown, 27 minutes. As we take you back outside, TransGuide traffic cameras again, traffic looking pretty good. I have to say, even though it's 6:30, expect things to pick up a little bit, but people pretty much taking care of themselves out there in the roadways this morning. Sarah, Stephanie, back to you guys.
RJ, thank you. Angry words have led to gunfire at a northeast side apartment complex.
San Antonio police say one of the men involved in that dispute was shot.
Our Katrina Weber, she's live where it happened on Fairdale Drive. That's near Riddiman Road and I-35. Now, Katrina, have police found the shooter yet?
No, and it's not for lack of trying. At one point, they had the helicopter up. They've also been working here on the ground, trying to gather whatever clues they can to lead them to that shooter. Take a look at what's been going on since right before 5 o'clock this morning. Again, these are the Parker apartment homes, and this is where the shooting happened. Police believe whatever sort of disturbance or fight there was started in the laundry room of this apartment complex, but the victim obviously ended up here in the middle of the parking lot. You can see his shoes right there, along with one of the paramedic gloves. Police say they also found blood in this area. A 25-year-old man who was shot in his stomach and arm, according to police. They say non-life-threatening wounds, but he is at a hospital getting treatment right now. Police have, they were working in and around one apartment here in particular, and we saw them bring someone out in handcuffs, but they tell us that that was just sort of a preventive measure that they took, that he at this point is not a suspect in this case. The person who they're looking for described as wearing a red hoodie and having dreadlocks, and that's about all the information that police had about that. They don't know the reason for this dispute, some sort of a fight or argument that then led to a shooting early this morning. Reporting live on the northeast side, Katrina Weber, KSAT 12 News.
Katrina, thank you. New this morning, a man is behind bars accused of trying to set a woman's apartment on fire. 26-year-old Dominique Rogers is accused of arson. An arrest affidavit says Rogers showed up to a woman's apartment who he knew and threatened her with a knife. The woman told police he lit a T-shirt on fire and threw it on her balcony, saying he was going to make sure she didn't have a place to live. The woman put the fire out with a pot of water. Rogers' bond has been set for $75,000.
A hit-and-run crash and a councilman who is open to rehab to, quote, make sure this will never happen again. District 10 Councilman Clayton Perry is being granted a sabbatical by fellow council members. Now, Perry is accused of running from the scene of a crash. This leave of his duties does come after a unanimous vote of no confidence against Perry from City Council, except for Perry and Mario Bravo, who abstained from voting. But it came only after most of council voted to remove language in its resolution that it would have asked Perry to resign. District 8 Councilman Manny Pelaez explained why.
Taking him at his word today that he is sorry, that he needs this help, doesn't seek the medical and rehabilitation services that he knows he needs, that's on him.
Now, the police body cam video of an encounter with Perry raised concerns of him driving while intoxicated. Last week, San Antonio police told KSET they would file a DWI charge with the district attorney's office. Now, yesterday afternoon, the DA said that hadn't happened yet. We have asked the San Antonio Police Department through email where things stand with that potential charge, but we have not heard back yet.
The Uvalde CISD Moving Forward Foundation, the Community Advisory Committee, hosted a community meeting to showcase work they've done on designing a new elementary school. Conceptual designs for the new elementary school were shown, as well as a breakdown of the number of classrooms and safety accommodations. The foundation committee also agreed on a location for the new school near Dalton Elementary. Fundraising efforts to raise an estimated $50 million are underway. So far, the foundation has raised $18 million. While construction is a ways off, community members feel this is a step in the right direction.
I think that things are finally coming together, and it does look like the input has been really positive.
The next step is for the foundation committee to present this to the school board at their Wednesday meeting for them to vote on a site selection for the campus and the conceptual design. The hope is to have the school ready by October of 2024.
And after a nearly 13-hour manhunt, a University of Virginia student is in police custody this morning.
He's accused of killing three fellow students. ABC's Andrew Dimbert has the story.
Overnight, shock and sadness on the campus of the University of Virginia, where a student is accused of killing three members of the football team.
I think that this whole community will forever be changed.
It's a lot right now. It's kind of all very surreal.
The players were on this bullet-riddled bus returning from a class trip when authorities say Christopher Darnell Jones Jr. opened fire, killing Devin Chandler, Lavelle Davis Jr., and Deshaun Perry. The university police chief learned of Jones's arrest in the middle of a news conference.
Just need a moment to thank God. Breathe a sigh of relief.
Jones is a former member of the football team. It's unclear why he allegedly opened fire on the bus. The police chief revealed Jones was already on their radar, saying the university's threat assessment team learned about Jones in September after someone said he had boasted about having a gun. The chief also said Jones faced a previous hazing investigation.
I don't know the facts and circumstances of that investigation. I know that it was eventually closed due to witnesses that would not cooperate with the process.
Andrew Dimbert, ABC News, New York.
Some other top stories we're following for you this morning. Massive layoffs are reportedly coming to Amazon. The New York Times says the company is set to cut 10,000 jobs just this week. That's the most in its history. The layoffs will reportedly affect the division responsible for the Alexa voice services, as well as retail and human resources.
It comes as Amazon founder Jeff Bezos says he plans to give away most of his estimated $124 billion fortune during his lifetime. It's not clear exactly when he will distribute that money. Bezos says the money will be devoted to fighting climate change and other causes.
Don't forget our KSAC Community Share the Shoes campaign. It's happening right now. You can donate a new pair of shoes or socks to a child in need.
Just take your donation to any of the San Antonio Police substations through December 16th. This donation drive benefits Zapatos, which works with schools to help kids get the shoes they need.
You can find more information on our KSAC Community page on KSAT.com.
Time now, 6:39, and we're starting in the 40s right now.
Still ahead on GMSA, why health experts say more and more kids and teenagers are getting addicted to nicotine.
And welcome back. It is 6:43. So more kids and teenagers are getting hooked on nicotine.
Experts say a big reason for the spike is because of the growing popularity of e-cigarettes. So according to the new CDC data, e-cigarettes are used among middle and high school students rose by about 24% from a year ago.
Kids and teens may be turning to vaping as a result of marketing targeted towards a younger crowd. You will often see e-cigarettes and vape pens sold in glossy displays with flavors like bubblegum, jelly beans, and strawberry milkshake.
Health experts say parents should question their children about nicotine use and talk to them about the danger of addiction.
And there's Hank with the shades and the beard. No Shave November is in full swing, and you have probably seen a big change on a lot of our guys here at KSAT.
Yeah, everyone has a reason for participating. Here's why the very handsome and suave Jonathan Cotto says he is doing it.
Hey folks, I'm Jonathan Cotto, and I'm making this video to let you know that cancer sucks, and it sucks for everyone that is going through the oftentimes painful treatment. So anything you can donate would be of great help, especially for those who have received that diagnosis. Again, this is for research, awareness, and more importantly, prevention.
We were giving Jonathan a hard time because he's got this smolder picture.
Yes, he
does. I mean, it just hands down. It's just so handsome. The lighting's so good.
Yeah, and look, and now he's in fourth place.
Right.
With $545.
He gave the people what they wanted.
Yes.
And now, RJ, you need to do the same. Let's give a plug for RJ.
Yeah.
You know, get him up on that
smolder,
leaderboard.
RJ. Smolder.
Smolder.
I tried earlier. I've got a little bit more coffee in me now, so maybe I could do it.
You can pull off the smolder.
Yes, sir.
Well, speaking of donating, go ahead and go to this QR code right there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so you can donate to No Shave. This is on our website. And you can also learn more about this whole fundraising event.
Do like a Zoolander
look or
something?
Do it.
Oh, there you go. With a blue steel.
Blue steel. Come on.
Blue steel.
You know, it's nice at last check. Oh, there.
There it is.
There you go.
Oh,
there you go.
Yeah.
They put you on the
smile.
Spot.
Don't smile. Yeah. Work it.
Oh. Work it. Work it. I like the little turn.
Stay your mom over here.
At last check, we were in first place in the country.
Nice.
With more than $6,000. Of course, last year we finished second place in the nation. And not only are there various cancer charities, about 13 of them that we've all kind of picked, but it raises awareness, you know, for the guys. Breast Cancer Awareness Month in October, but for men, you know, just go to the doctor regularly.
Yeah.
Get yourself checked out.
Yeah, for sure.
Do it. And donate.
And donate to RJ.
Please do.
Who's also working double duty.
Smoldering out here. Things not really smoldering out on the roads this morning as traffic looking pretty good, starting out with our TransGuide traffic cameras. Making our way through the city of San Antonio, Loop 410 Ingram North. There's a exit block there, but again, not causing too much of an issue there. I-10 at Frio, things looking pretty good. Our normal backup as people make their way into downtown. This is something we've been kind of following. It looks like there's some fire department activity there. That is on Hackberry Street, but so they may have blocked off some roads, but again, nothing major to kind of note in the downtown area. As we move a little bit further north, and we see that we have a stall now on the southbound lanes of 281 at Donella Drive. So just keep that in mind if you are headed out in the Hollywood Park area. That's where that's being reported right now. But again, traffic moving pretty smooth out there. And Mike, how are things looking as far as our weather?
Well, as you can see, you got some sunshine there in the background, a few clouds as well. By the way, after the fire smolders, what comes then? The ash. What color is ash?
Team gray hair.
Gray? Come on, team gray hair.
I see your plug.
Thank you very much. I was going with that one. Look at this guy. I don't know if he's happy about the little red antlers, but.
Cute. Very cute, though.
Yeah, stuck with them, pal. Sorry about that. Scan that QR code and download some of your KSAC Connect pictures for us. And speaking of sunshine, there's some of the clouds that moved on in here, and we've got a lot of it. Make sure you take your sunglasses, and you will need them throughout the day. Here's some of those mid-high clouds that have started to slide on in. We'll keep some of these around throughout the day. I'm still going to call it mostly sunny skies, though. Later on, it's just going to be a lot of those high clouds. 40 here in town, 36 Belverde, and right around freezing. Maybe freezing in your backyard heading out I-10 in toward Bernie Stage Comfort as well as Kerrville, 37 in Helotes, and then wind chill temperatures, 35 Rio Medina at the airport, 36 Belverde, and then you got some 20s for wind chills out there in parts of the hill country. So needless to say, bundle up. And we're going to keep enough of a breeze around today, even though formulas really don't come into play above 50. Still going to feel colder than what it is later on this afternoon. We will stay pretty steady right now with these clouds out here and some of this breeze and then start to warm up a little bit, if you want to call it warm up, only 52 at noon. So we're just finally back up to the normal low temperature basically at noon. And then we top off at 58 later on today. And we'll have more, like I said, more sunshine, some of those high clouds, decent breeze out there. So you want to stay bundled up. Again, this is a huge Arctic air mass covering almost all of the country, with the exception of the deep southeast down there around Florida. But I mean, a lot of freezing temperatures around the country as of right now, and even 4 degrees up there at Cutbank, Montana. So for us today, it stays cold, and it's going to stay cold, kind of jumping ahead of myself here, but all the way through the forecast. 52 at noon, partly cloudy skies, a lot of those high clouds out there, and then a high temperature up to 58. That's it. 10 to 15 degrees below normal. Tomorrow, Thursday, pretty much the same thing, close to freezing in the hill country, and then getting up into the upper 50s. Friday, a lot more clouds. We've got the next front moving on in here, and we're going to see kind of like what happened last week with those clouds started overrunning that colder air. Stays cloudy on Friday, then the cold air really settles in here, and only 49 on Saturday with some rain. That makes you shiver just looking at it.
No, so make sure you bundle up, cover the head, the ears, the scarf. I know a lot of people are getting colds right now. It's kind of cold and flu season.
That is very true.
Stay nice and bundled up. Wash your hands too.
All of the reminders. Time now, 6:49, and we are still in the cold 40s right now.
Postpartum depression is something that can have a big impact on families. Tomorrow on GMSA, the signs of postpartum anxiety and what treatments can help.
And another look out there with live cam. Beautiful out there. It's just cold though. Don't be fooled by the sun. Go ahead and bundle up for your day, and then maybe it'll warm up just a tad in the afternoon. We'll be right back.
Good morning. ABC News is projecting Democrat Katie Hobbs as Arizona's governor-elect, defeating Republican Kerry Lake, a 2020 election denier who earned the backing of former President Trump, who could be now just hours from announcing his own re-election campaign today.
Thank you.
In Arizona, a razor-thin race for governor now called. ABC News projecting Democrat Katie Hobbs as the winner. Hobbs tweeting that democracy is worth the wait. Her opponent, Kerry Lake, tweeting Arizonans know BS when they see it. ABC News estimating Republicans are ahead of Democrats in the race to a 218-seat House majority. Across the Capitol, Democrats have secured Senate control with wins in Arizona and Nevada.
The reason we won, and they know it, the candidates know it, is we focused on things that matter to everyday Americans.
Both parties now eager to win Georgia's December runoff Senate race between incumbent Democrat Raphael Warnock and Republican Herschel Walker. ABC's David Muir interviewing former Vice President Pence ahead of former President Trump's likely 2024 announcement today. The former VP refusing to say if he believes Trump should serve again as president.
David, I think that's up to the American people.
With Trump's 2024 re-election launch widely expected today, calls are growing for him to delay that announcement, with the Georgia Senate runoff looming and the underperformance of Trump-backed candidates. Justin Finch, ABC News, Washington.
All right, quick look at traffic, taking you outside Trans Guide traffic cameras. Things have been going well all morning long. Loop 410 and Marbach, things looking solid there. Biggest thing we're following right now is a stall. This is on the eastbound lanes of 90 at 36th Street, but again, does not seem to be causing too much of a delay there. And as far as our wide view, you could just see our normal kind of buildup traffic areas, people coming in from Castroville up north in the north side Stone Oak area. There is some traffic buildup, but again, things looking very good this Tuesday morning. Mike, how is it looking?
Not bad. We got some clouds out there, as you can see. A lot of sunshine. Take your sunglasses. We'll have a lot of high clouds around today. We are down now to 38 degrees here in town and just above freezing in a good chunk of the hill country. So maybe below freezing in your backyard. And then we've got wind chill temperatures. Feels like 33 out there at the airport. Same thing Rio Medina. 26 is the wind chill at Kerrville. And enough of a breeze all day long. That 58 is going to be feeling much cooler than that. I'm going to call it mostly sunny skies, but we'll have a lot of those high clouds around here. Stays cold. Cold through the rest of the week and just a wet, bone chilling weekend.
Thanks, Mike. Thank you, RJ.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you back here at 9.